Welcome to Minute Maths. In this video we are going to explain the Pythagorean theorem, also known as Pythagoras's theorem, and how to use it. Subscribe, like, and comment down below. So, where does the name Pythagoras come from? Well, Pythagoras was a Greek mathematician, scientist, and philosopher, who has contributed to important developments in mathematics. And what is a theorem? A theorem is a statement that has been proved to be true. So, Pythagoras has been credited with the discovery of a theorem about right-angled triangles. We can use this theorem to calculate the length of a missing side of a right-angled triangle. To do this, we need to know a little bit about these triangles. Firstly, the term right-angled triangle means that one of the interior angles within the triangle is a 90-degree angle. Secondly, we need to know what a hypotenuse is. A hypotenuse is the longest side of a right-angled triangle. It will always be the side opposite the right angle. Knowing which side is the hypotenuse is crucial when using the formula for Pythagoras's theorem. So let's have a look at the formula. It reads as a squared plus b squared equals c squared. But what does this mean? Well, it means that if we square the length of side A and square the length of side B, then add them together, it is equal to the square of side C. To see a demonstration of how this works, see our video linked above. An important aspect of this is to label the sides of the triangle correctly. We label the sides of the triangle with A, B, and C. It doesn't matter which side you label as A and B, as long as it is not the hypotenuse. We always label the hypotenuse, the longest side, as C. So why do we use Pythagoras's theorem? As mentioned earlier, we use Pythagoras's theorem to find the missing length of a right-angled triangle. We can also use it to find the distance between two points. Learning how to use the formula and apply it in various ways can also help improve your problem-solving skills. So how do we do this? First, you may find it helpful to write down the formula each time you use it. Then label the sides A, B, and C, remembering that C is the hypotenuse. Next, we put the lengths of the sides we already know into the formula. The length of side A is 60, and the length of side B is 45. So here we have 60 squared, add 45 squared, equals C squared. Use a calculator, or pen and paper, to square the numbers. Now add these numbers together. 5625 is equal to the square of side C. To find out what the actual length of C is, we need to find out the square root of 5625. Finding the square root is an important step, as many learners sometimes forget that they have only calculated the square of the side, not the length of the side itself. Again, using your calculator or pen and paper, find the square root. So now we have found out that the length of side C is equal to 75. Sometimes you will have been given the length of the hypotenuse, but either A or B will be missing instead. In this case, we use the same formula, but with a bit of rearranging. So, in this instance, we change B and C in the formula to the relevant numbers, leaving the length of side A for us to find. So again, we square the numbers, but this time we have to rearrange the formula to get a squared on its own side of the equals sign. If you need a refresher on rearranging equations, see our video linked above. Therefore, a squared equals 192. Finally, we find the square root of 192 to get the length of the missing side. As the answer is a decimal number, we can round this appropriately, depending on what the question has asked for. Here are two practice questions for you to try. Pause the video while you work them out. Thanks for watching Minute Maths. We hope you are now able to use Pythagoras' theorem with ease. Check out the channel for more videos.